It's an honor for us. We're a big fan of your game. And yeah, you're a three-time champion, so it's really nice to talk to you today. We actually want to start in the beginning because you was kind of a high school prodigy and you went straight from high school to the NBA. So I was wondering, how hard was it to make that decision back then? And also, how hard was the transition to do that?
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for having me on. Appreciate the words as well. As far as the difficulty in that decision, it was very difficult. I had committed a long time back in high school to go to Duke University when the legendary Coach Krzyzewski was still coaching, still in his prime. I had committed to go there my senior year. I played my senior year out, and I started to see NBA scouts at our high school games. Steve Kerr was one of those guys that came to visit, ironically.
Was he with the Suns back then, or where was he?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. So full circle moment for me. And then just for the opportunity to go lottery, you know, when I did choose to go to the draft, you know, I kind of had a top 10 guarantee and, you know, those pretty good odds.
Yeah.
I had a decision to make. I had to call Coach K, let him know I wasn't coming. And I got drafted with the fourth pick in the 2004 NBA draft by the LA Clippers.
And in terms of what was the hardest for you transitioning wise from high school to the pros, because that's always a big leap.
I would say the most challenging part of that transition was the games, the schedule.
Mm-hmm.
I played 30 NBA games because of injuries my first year. And that was the equivalent of our high school season.
Yeah.
And then I missed, you know, the other two thirds of the season. You know, that was only a third, right? 82 mm-hmm. games, practice every day, traveling, getting in at, you know, 2-3 in the morning, adjusting. So the physicality for me, thin, skinny guy, was probably a 185, soaking wet and coming out of high school. So, you know, obviously playing against grown men and playing that schedule every night.
So you just mentioned injuries, and then obviously a few years later, you had that horrific injury. Can you maybe take us back as much as you remember? How did it feel as bad as it was in that moment? And how did you proceed the next weeks? Like how were the first weeks?
Yeah, good question. It was excruciating. Mm-hmm. the actual injury, you know, never felt pain like that before. I had dealt with injuries before in the knees my first year. So when I had the big one, you know, I thought it was something similar to what I had already gone through. And I remember riding in the ambulance with the assistant trainer, Johan Wang, who was actually our head trainer when I got to the Warriors, just so full circle. I mean, he was just kind of looking at me like, nah, buddy, this is different. The journey back was difficult because it's always the fear of the unknown and there was no timetable.
Yeah, and obviously the road back was pretty long. Was there ever a moment, even in the following years, you switched teams, you didn't play a lot of games. Was there ever a moment when you lost hope? Or was there a moment where you envisioned yourself being as successful as you then ended up being in Golden State?
Yeah, the hardest part was after the injury. You know, just feelings of depression a little bit, you know, just kind of you just see your life kind of flash in front of you a little bit as far as, you know, what am I going to do? Being 21 and no college degree, no background. And, you know, all my peers are off in school and figuring out what they want to do. And luckily, I had a little financial security, but, you know, I cared about playing and I wasn't able to do something I love to do. Also, the rehab process was very difficult because this was more in line with the car accident, more trauma victims. I tore 3 out of 4 ligaments and dislocated my femur and tibia, you know, which is your upper and lower leg, all at one time. And so a lot of rehab.
Yeah, but then you found a home in Golden State. You was very successful as someone back then rooting for the Cavaliers. I hated when you came in because I always knew you was a bucket. You always had this turnaround fadeaway. You had this mid-range game. It was always tough to watch for me, but I also admired it and respected it. What made Golden State such a great opportunity for you, or such a great home where you could feel, where you could get back to becoming a great player and a champion?
Yeah, I knew I spotted a Cavs fan somewhere amongst these faces.
Yeah.
You know, it was kind of destiny. in a sense of the way it aligned up. Like I mentioned, you know, just my history with, you know, Steve Kerr, you know, seeing me as a young prodigy and just kind of getting a chance to know a little bit about me, but also my journey before I got there. You know, I think I had two pretty good years in my eyes as far as staying healthy. You know, I'd played, you know, up to 70 something games, which was, you know, again, a big feat for me throughout my career as I was battling my body. And then I think as well, just when I came to the team in 2014, you know, there was a lot of veterans on this team that I had played either with or against and that I had relationships with. A couple of those guys, Andrew Bogut in Milwaukee, Mo Spakes in Cleveland, you know, I battled against Leandro Barbosa, you know, in the Phoenix days, you know, when I was with the Clippers, we played in the playoffs. So just having relationships with those guys. And then, of course, Andre Iguodala, you know, final 2015 finals MVP. We've known each other since we were 11 years old. We grew up 45 minutes apart, you know. Okay. So I think all of those relationships, you know, it was kind of a built-in chemistry. You know, when we got to each other, the stars kind of aligned. We were all kind of in our 9th, 10th year in the NBA. We had kind of seen what the, you know, what the road was like, you know, what it took to win. And we'd all gone through our individual journeys of success and failure. And then you obviously put that together with budding stars and, you know, Steph, Clay, and Draymond.
Okay, so you just talked about the physical part of that run with the Warriors and how challenging it was and how important recovery is. Can you also talk a little bit about the mental aspect? Because you went to the finals for 5 straight years, always playing Ting Jun, close to 100 games. How tough is it to stay mentally ready to do this every year and always have a target on your back as a defending champion?
How much time do we have? I mean, man, that's really, you know, of course, health, you know, the best ability is availability. You know, as I heard, for me, I think it was tough just because, you know, once you climb the mountain, right, trying to stay there, you know, I think once we have our sights set on goals and, you know, we have our visions and we're driven by purpose, it's a lot easier to, you know, do what we come to do. But, you know, staying there, because success breeds complacency in that way. And that's, I think that's why we kind of define greatness as sustained success. You know, with, you see Tom Brady and, you know, what LeBron and certain guys are able to do for so long in their careers. But yeah, it's the mental grind. You know, it's the mental grind, the day-to-day, having a target on your back, you know, winning championships. You know, there are no nights off as far as everybody's gunning for you, every team in the league. It's the NBA, you know, there's good players everywhere. So just year after year, making that climb, you don't want to say you have to pace yourself, but you don't want to get burnout. And it's very hard to do, you know, year after year.
All right. Then we'd like to just thank you for coming on the show. That was really insightful. And for guys like us who grew up watching you, kind of started with the NBA right when you came in, this was really special for us. So thank you very much for the insight and best of luck for the rest of the season.
Yes, sir. Thank you guys for having me on.